Hello and welcome to another round of Pokemon Trading Card Game Online. Today we are trying another new deck with cards from the Forbidden Light extension. So in the last 4-5 days I played a number of decks. As you know, I played an improved Buzzwall deck, I played the Ultra Necrozma Malama. In just the last couple of days, I really lost a lot of times with those decks. A lot of times I just had bad luck with the draws, or maybe my skills are too weak there and I'm not experienced enough with those decks. But I figured out I'm gonna build another deck, and I built a deck around the new Zygarde GX. What I figured out is what Zygarde GX really requires is a good draw engine and availability to a lot of cards. And the Pokemon which can give this to us is Zoroark GX. And I'm a big fan of Zoroark GX. I've been playing many games with Zoroark Lucario, Zoroark Lycanroc. So I figured out, okay, let's give Zoroark Zygarde a chance. And it actually worked. I played, I think, 4 matches so far with it, and I won all 4. Now that's not statistically relevant yet. That might have been a coincidence, but I think at least it means we should give this deck a chance and play some more games with it. So this deck features a full line of 4 Zoroark and 4 Zoroark GXs. Zoroark GX here A used for obviously its trait ability, so we can get more cards which we need actually. Zygarde is only really good if you have access to a lot of cards, so you can pull off these combos with Bonnie, Stadiums, Energies and so on, so that's important. But Zoroark here also can be effectively used as an attacker. One of the games I played with this deck was against Blizzipod, and since Zygarde is weak to grass, I pretty much just used Zoroark as a main attacker and was able to win. Other decks from the new extension in here is a new Diancie Prism Star, which gives our Zygarde 20 more damage every time it attacks. And then obviously Zygarde itself. So let's have a look at this card. It's a basic GX with 200 HP, so it's a very beefy, obviously strong Pokemon. It has a first attack with Cell Connector, which just requires a double colorless attachment, does 50 damage, and it allows us then to attach 2 fighting energies from your discard pile to the Pokemon, meaning it pretty much readies itself for its stronger attacks, as long as we have these fighting energies in the discard pile. So you will see Zoroark also with trait can help us get fighting energies in the discard pile quickly. And then we have Lanceros, which does 130, but really what we are interested here is a GX attack with 150. And not only 150, but then preventing all damage done to this Pokemon by any attacks from GX and EX Pokemon during our opponent's next attack. So in all likelihood, we won't get a lot of damage and will be able to do another knockout. In addition to that, we combine that with a new Bonnie supporter card. And Bonnie can only be played if there's a stadium card in play. So you see, we play a bunch of stadiums here. And it requires us to discard the stadium card, but then we can use the GX attack even if we used already a GX attack, which is crazy. So we definitely want to pull this off. And as I mentioned, in order to pull it off, we need to have stadium cards. I decided to put 4 parallel cities in here. Parallel cities, A, good to disrupt our opponents, but also good to avoid our opponent playing parallel city and then limiting the damage which we can do with Zoroark GX. So you will see that card certainly come into action. Other Pokemons I play, 1 Mew for the Buzzwall decks. That might be not enough, I might up that, but for now 1 Mew, 2 Tapu Lele, and then I also play the Bridgets here. So the typical Zoroark, I play Tapu Lele, find the Bridget, and get tons of Zoroars, probably 3 Zoroars and 1 Zygarde on the bench. In order to find those double colorless, which are critical, obviously both for Zoroark and for Zygarde, I play 1 Energy Lotto. We have 2 Field Blowers, 4 Puzzle of Times, which allows us to go back later and We get back those discarded cards which resulted from the discards from trade. We have 4 Ultra Ball to find our Pokemon. We play 2 Cynthia, 3 Gasma, 1 Mellow, which allows us to pick out exactly the cards which we can get with the trade. 2 N and only 1 Sycamore. So Sycamore here is actually not that relevant, since we can trade a lot, and in general Zoroark decks have that challenge that they can deck out, because we're gonna do so many trades. So 1 Sycamore I think is sufficient here. 2 Choice Bands, 2 Float Stones, and then we play 4 Double Colorless and 7 regular Fighting Energy. So with that, let's just dig in. I'm gonna post, obviously, as usual, a copy of the deck list in the description of this YouTube video. So let's see, let's at least get one game done before I head out for dinner tonight. So the good thing about this deck, it's easy to find since it's a ZZ, right? Zoroark Zygarde, so it's the end here. And we're gonna start our match. So let's see if we can continue the win streak. I currently have the win streak of 3 games. Let's see if we can make that 4. So we're playing against the deck with Psychic and Fighting. So probably some Buzzwall variant, which is will make it challenging for us, but that's fine. Let's see what we can do. So pretty good. So we have a Zygarde. Probably want to bring this already out. We have a Zora, we have a DCE. That's good. So let's bring the Zora out. We have already 2 Zoroark, which we obviously can't evolve in the first turn, so let's see what happens. If I can somehow figure out how to get some energies into the discard pile, we can use Cell Connector. He has Zygarde. Okay, he uses the old Zygarde EX. Okay, so this is kind of the Fighting crew. There is a name for this deck. Fighting guys or so. It has a bunch of different fighting Pokemons. So 190. So what we want to do is, I think we still want to attach the double colorless. He might play, however, Enhanced Hammer, which would be annoying. But I think we're gonna go ahead, put the DCE on here. And then unfortunately we don't have any other cards, so that's fine, so we are done. Meaning however, next turn we can actually evolve. And okay, he plays N, so let's see what we get. But if we get the Zoroark, we can evolve, potentially discard one fighting energy, attach one, and then get ready for... Okay, so still good. We have also the Parallel City. If he doesn't play it, we can play it. And then we should be in good shape. So yeah, he has a enhanced fighting guy. So he has Zygarde, he plays a Regirock, he plays a Diancie, he plays a Buzzwall. So it's interesting. I see a bunch of people playing both. Not sure if this is a good idea. So what we want to do here, obviously we want to evolve. Okay, so he did 70, next he could do 140, or with Cell Storm, he can do some more, Stadium Card in play, he can do more. How did he do 70 already? Okay, 30, yeah, with all the enhancers here. So let's say he does the next one, Cell Storm, 60 plus 20, 80, 90, 90 plus 70, 100, 50. 160. Okay, let's see what we can do. So let's put out the Parallel City. Done. Let's do a trade for one of the energies. And then let's see. Maybe we bring out this Regirock and just start attacking and maybe even block him. So we can do this with a Gasma. We have a Float Stone in place. Let's go this way. So I'm gonna go for the Regirock, the Float Stone, retreat, bring this guy back, attach a fighting energy, and then we gonna do a Cell Connector. And we grab another fighting energy, attach it, and see if our opponent has an answer to retreat the Regirock. So he would need a Floatstone, or he would need to play Gasma. Plays Sins here, so Gasma is out of the question, so Floatstone is still an option for him. Okay, put the choice band. So he doesn't have it. Alright, so what we can do, we don't want to play the Bonnie, obviously. We probably want to play an, or we want to trade. What do we want to do? So we attack here, we clearly knock him out. He can't attack on the next turn. So I think that's a pretty good situation. I don't even want to get rid of the... I think I'm gonna just do a trade. And we're gonna trade, let's say, actually the N. So we have a Bridget here, which we can play since we don't need it. Any specific Pokemon this turn. We are fully attached, so let's just do a Bridget here. We're gonna pick one of those guys. We're gonna pick a Mew. And let's see, should we pick another? Let's get another Zygarde ready as well. And let's put for now this energy on the Mew. And then we're gonna attack with the GX attack. 150, knock him effectively out. Okay. Hey, what happened with our internet connection? That's scary. Looks all fine. That's very weird. Okay, so we're gonna get two prize cards. Guzma, which comes in handy, and a choice band, which will come in handy as well for Zygarde. So he hopefully knows that he can't attack unless he plays a Guzma and gets rid of a Zoroark. Might do that, let's see. And then we're just gonna come back with a Zygarde, the Bonnie Zygarde combo, and do another Whirling GX. Place a Sycamore, so no Guzma. So that means in the next turn we're gonna knock out the Diancy. Okay. So let's evolve here. Eventually we want to get our Diancy. I don't even know if I saw it. It might be in the prizes. I think we want to attach a choice band. We want to play Bonnie to do another GX, okay, and we want to do some trades. Let's trade away the Zora. I think two are good. We get a DCE, which is awesome, which we probably want to put on this Zygarde, and then let's do another. So he has a choice band on here. Let's just do another trade for this Field Blower. We can always get it back later with Puzzle of Time if needed. So now we have two Puzzle of Time, which is awesome. We have a Floatstone. Probably want to put on... which Pokemon? Maybe on this Zygarde. And then we're gonna do another Verdict GX to knock out this Diancie. And we are immune for another round. And we have a parallel city. So potentially if we find another Bonnie, we will just continue with Verdict GX. We also have the Guzma. Anything which we want to Guzma, this side got 190. So he is starting with Guzma. Okay. So obviously he will have an easy time against our Zoroark. Okay. And with 3, we are in a kind of tricky situation. If he plays B-string, he can attach tons of energy, but he didn't play B-string. So, let's just bring this guy out again for now. And let's get rid of this Bridget. Let's see what we get. let's bring out the Beyonce to do some more damage. We have a choice band. So let's say we do the 130 plus 100, plus 30 is 160, 180, we need 190. So ideally we need to do the GX attack, which we don't have the card. But we can obviously bring it back with Puzzle of Time. So let's bring this guy out. Done. Two Puzzle of Time. So what do we want to bring back? We definitely want to bring back a Bonnie. And what else? Kuzma, Holster, no. Maybe the Zora, so we can get another one of those guys out. Doesn't make sense. And then we play Bonnie. And we're gonna do another Verdict GX for the knockout. Okay, so now we have only one more card which we need to take here in order for the win. And we get a bunch of energies. Let's see what he is up to. So he brings out the Oranguru with a Float Stone. That gives him all options. So he's gonna go for the Buzz Wall. 160 plus strong energy, 180. And the Guzma. Interesting. Oh yeah, he couldn't attack this one, so he needs to attack this Zygarde. And then we need to find a way. Yeah, this is pretty much game for us, because we will just Guzma out this Oranguru, and that's game. Okay. Okay, so we gonna Guzma the Oranguru. Bring back our trusted Zygarde here and play Lanthras for the game. So this is a fourth win in a row with a deck here against a very good deck, Buzzwall, obviously with our weakness. Certainly nothing to underestimate, but we were able to pull it off, so I continue to be very optimistic. Optimistic enough that I did some trades to get more Zygardes. I only had two Zygardes GX. I just did a trade for a couple of packs to get another Zygarde, because my feeling is this is a sleeper deck which more people will become aware of, and Zygarde GX might become more expensive to trade. So if you at all are interested, this is the time. I think Zygarde can be traded for about 3 to 4 packs. So if you have some spare packs and you don't have yet Zygarde GX, definitely recommend to get one. I think that's it for today. I'm probably heading out for dinner fairly soon here. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to subscribe and like. I'm sure Max will do some videos this weekend as well. And we see you guys later. Bye.